FM News Talk 97.1.
On-demand audio.
FM News Talk 97.1.
On-demand audio. Common Sense Radio.
Good morning, you bunch of drunks.
Coming up in just an hour, Dr. Tolbert going to be joining us. Also, we're getting an update on the last remnants of the Missouri legislative session. The fate of minimum wage increases and everything else. Also, taking your phone calls on what you think about your tax dollars being used for the Rams Dome Stadium, the retractable stadium. We'll have that for you, too. You see this story? It's in New Jersey. This is where sometimes people just are so funny about. Even conservatives will oftentimes, if they don't like something, will default to the government kind of managing it for them instead of relying, even though sometimes it can be difficult, for society to correct itself. And I know that's kind of it's not an easy thing, because a lot of people will compare it to parenting. And kids, for instance, do need discipline, and they need boundaries. And they need you to be all over them. Boys in particular, I don't know what the deal is. I was just thinking about this last night. I don't know what it is with my two boys. I got to be on them like white on rice constantly. Slapping them upside the head all the time. But boys for whatever reason needs to be managed more than girls do. I don't know why that is, but they do. And... Aiden's going to kill one of these girls sooner or later. He just is, you know. And here's the problem. Like, for instance, and I'm digressing here, but I'm getting to a point. He's got this rocket thing that whistles, okay? It's one of those torpedo things you throw up in the air. It's really cool, actually. And actually, you get it really, really high. That baby will whistle like a mother when it comes down. But heaven forbid it comes down on you, because it's painful. So, of course... Because I guarantee you, I can pretty much just count. I was like, all right, so Aiden and Natalie go outside or go into a room together somewhere. And I'm like, okay, I'll give it a minute. Natalie will be crying, guaranteed. 60 seconds. Ah, here comes Natalie. What happened? Aiden, blah, 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 blah. And so anyway. So, because he's always, and it's all, sometimes it's like he's kicking a ball or something and it winds up popping her in the stomach or something. You know, it's just like that kind of stuff. It's like, Aiden, come on. So anyway, he throws this thing up in the air and it comes down and it hits Natalie at the little Mother's Day gathering. And of course it hits Natalie, and I'm inside cooking and getting stuff together and going back and forth between the grill, and they're outside and with the family and everything else. And, Natalie comes in, and I say, what happened? She goes, Aiden hit me with the torpedo thing. And I go outside, and, you know, and the minute I go outside, all my sisters are like, it was an accident. It was an accident. He didn't mean to hurt her. I go, let me handle this, okay? Because I try to tell Aiden, there aren't accidents. You're not being careful around the girls. That's the problem. It's not an accident when Natalie's running around or Lily's running around and you throw the torpedo up in the air and you're in a space of about 10 square feet. It's going to come down on one of the girls. And because I guarantee you, it's not coming out on you. You'll get out of the way. So anyway, so that's what I'm trying to tell. So the women are all coddling him, you know. Oh, no, it's just an accident. And I try to tell them, with Aiden, it's, and boys, there are no accidents. It's about being irresponsible and not being considerate of things around you. That's the biggest problem with boys.
I feel like it's like I feel like I've had this conversation with Mia before. So it's not just the girls.
Oh, right, that's true. It'll get to that when Natalie starts to injure Lily. I know that'll happen. But anyway, but still, but that's with the boys. Like, you got to be, you know, you got to manage it. So anyway, kids do need direction. They do need boundaries. They do need limitations. It makes them feel secure when you're on them. People don't realize that. Freedom is like the worst thing for kids. Mm-hmm. Because they don't feel comfortable and secure. So anyway, the opposite is true with society, where we try to promote freedom and liberty. And the fact of the matter is, as adults, sometimes it's not going to go our way. We're going to have to put up with people who have T-shirts on or who do things that we don't like. But we have to like liberty more than we are concerned about our own personal views on things. Now, within reason, obviously, just killing somebody or doing something like that. You understand what I'm saying. But as adults and as a society, we want liberty to be important. And so, for instance, we had a guy call yesterday about gay marriage, and I'm not going to obsess over this gay thing anymore, but who said, well, I don't want to see two people holding hands and it's going to have an impact on my kid. I go, well, actually, no, you have the impact on your child. You have that impact. And so hopefully society will, you know, kind of correct itself. And the problem is we have no shame anymore. Like, people will do things and nobody will call them out. Like, you'll see people doing something at a Walgreens or whatever, but nobody says, what the hell are you doing, dude? You know? I mean, nobody will say anything to them. Now, I'm not saying you need to start a fight all the time or do this kind of thing, but, you know, it's amazing what people will... Like, for instance, live near a gas station, and, you know, these idiots, the gas station it's dark, okay? People will still stop at the gas station and try to pump gas into their cars, thinking it's closed, you know? They're idiots. And so every once in a while, you gotta go, dude, it's closed. There are no lights on at the gas station. Why are you outside of the pump pumping gas, you idiot? So anyway, we don't do that anymore. And so therefore, we wind up in a situation where you always want the government to start managing things for you. This is the case where people, you know, the whole texting and walking thing. Check it out.
We know the dangers of texting and driving, and we've also seen the dangers of texting and walking. Now, one city in New Jersey is doing something about it. Police in Fort Lee say since January, they've spotted 23 pedestrian accidents due to texting. They tried sending out pamphlets, but now the police chief has fed up. He's sick and tired of it, so he's ordered officers to start handing out tickets instead to those careless pedestrians on the spot. As of right now, there's no penalty, but there could be costs coming if this problem
That's all we need is a police force out there handing out tickets for which there is no penalty. You know, and then you talk about government and society running amok. Why don't we just instead, when you are walking behind somebody who is texting, okay, and you're trying to walk because you actually have somewhere to go, okay, because you have a purpose in life, either if you can't move around the guy, celebrate, dude, get your head up out of your rear end of your phone and walk forward because you're bothering me, okay? Let's start calling people out instead of having government do it for us. It's a long way to go for that, wasn't it? But it was fun.
Allman in the morning.
Plus, I love the woman saying, let's correct the problem before it gets worse. That's like an anchor at a local news station. All right. Coming up, Dr. Tolbert, and we'll get an update on the waning days of the Missouri legislative session. Straight ahead.